Hey everybody, it's Brandon, the weekend cruiser, where I go on a weekend cruise just about every weekend. I am in Royal Caribbean's private island, CocoCay, today, and I came in on a different ship. Normally, I'm here on the Freedom of the Seas, but today I came in on the Adventure of the Seas. But I still feel right at home. Both ships are here with me today, but I wanted to chat through the different beaches at CocoCay. So if you look at the map of CocoCay, it looks like there's three different beaches that are here, but I will tell you, they really have about 9 different beaches that you can choose from during your time at CocoCay. So majority of those are gonna be complimentary. You can just go and hang out whenever you want to. But at the end of this video, I wanna make sure that I'm really covering one that you can pay extra money to go into. So let's check out the different beaches here and see which one is gonna be the right fit for your visit to CocoCay. If you like this video and want to stay up to date on all things weekend cruising, make sure that you're sailing on into the subscribe button down below, giving us that thumbs up, and so that you can stay up to date on all things weekend cruising and Royal Caribbean in general. So here is beach number one that is honestly not even on the map. So I'm going to be referencing this chart or this map that Royal Caribbean has put out to showcase what beaches you can go to. And this one doesn't even exist. And I can kind of understand why. It is the smallest of all of the beaches and it has some beautiful chairs here, but it does not have actual access to the water. But what it does have for any cruise geeks like myself are beautiful views of the ships. So if you are in port and you are a cruise fan like myself, you love geeking out about cruises, this could very well be the beach for you. I will say that this area normally has nobody sitting in it. It's also gonna appeal to those people that just want to get away, not be part of the crowd, and kind of separate themselves. Today, there was one person with two ships in port at this beach. So again, no access to water. It's gonna be pretty quiet. They do have an easy to access bar right beside of it, but the real selling point to this, it's gonna be those beautiful ships right behind me. So now I am on Chill Beach. This is the first beach of Chill Island, and Chill Island, if you'll notice on the map, does take up majority of CocoCay, but this is the first section to Chill Island, and I think all of them have a little bit of their own flair and flavor to them. This is the first beach that you get to once you walk over the bridge. It's the easiest to get to, and because of that, I think you're gonna have more people that stop here because they just find a chair and they're gonna take it. There's easy access to the bar that's in the middle of this section, and the second section that I'm going to take you to, plenty of umbrellas for everybody to sit under, and even some cabanas if you want to rent one of those for an additional charge. The pool here, or the water, is actually really nice. It's easy to walk into, and it is going to be right there for you to enjoy the entire day. When coming to the beach at CocoCay, in between sections 1 and 2 of Chill Island, you're gonna find this beach warning flag sign that is behind me. So those are gonna be posted behind the lifeguard stands, but make sure that you are paying attention to those. Oftentimes on the island, you're gonna see the purple flag being flown for the marine life because there are jellyfish out there, as well as stingrays that you're gonna be able to see. And every now and again, some small little nerf sharks or baby sharks that you're gonna see in the water. But if we move on to section 2 of Chill Island, as I call it, you're gonna see that this is a really nice island. It's similar to the first. It's going to split the bar in the middle here, so you're gonna have easy access to both of those. But this section is really known for its snorkeling. So if you wanna go snorkeling, section 2 of Chill Island is where you're gonna want to go. Even if you go about 100 meters out, you're going to see an airplane that they have buried underneath the water, and it has a lot of great fish, especially around the airplane. In addition to around the jetties or the rocks that they've put out there, you're gonna see a lot of really colorful fish. So for those snorkeling, this is the ideal place to do it. I think this area also has less people. So if you're looking for a beach location that's gonna have not as crowded of an environment, I think section 2 is a good choice. And welcome to section 3 of Chill Island. So this, I think, is one of the most popular spaces on Chill Island because of the sports activity. So if you've rented a kayak, you've rented a mat, you're gonna find all of those here. You also have more cabanas further over that you're gonna be able to rent. But when I was looking at the water, and I've seen the water here many times, there's a lot of people that like to go swimming in this space. There's a lot of chairs to choose from, but again, if it's more popular, those are going to fill up a little bit quicker. For bar access, there's two that you can go to. One is going to be directly behind the chairs, and there's another one further towards section 4 that I'll show you in a moment. The bar here, though, is actually pretty cool. It is an Airstream travel trailer that you can get your drinks from, and they have all the offerings in there, even though it looks like a very small establishment. Chill Island section number 4 is probably one of the liveliest islands that are out there, and I'm gonna blame that on the closeness to all of the bars. It's also one of my favorite spots to hang out at CocoCay. So you are gonna have easy access to plenty of chairs here as well. Unlike some of the other spaces that have the umbrellas to cover you, here you can find wonderful palm trees to also cover you if you want to see more of the natural look for the location that you're going to be hanging out in. You're going to have, first of all, the bar behind me that I mentioned was in between section 3 and section 4. You can utilize it. You're also going to have the Airstream trailer that is directly behind all of these. But if you go out into the water, you're gonna have the floating cabana. You do have to swim out there, so go ahead and know that it's a little bit of a hike, not too terribly far. It does have a ladder to help you get up to it, so if you have any mobility issues, it could be something that will not work well for you. And they do not have any frozen drinks because there's no electricity out on the floating bar. So if you're ordering anything, make sure that it includes ice, but no crushed ice, as they're not gonna have electricity to run the blender. But this is definitely one of the most exciting bars in Chill Island, where a lot of people come. It's also where I've seen the most marine life out in the water. If you're on that floating bar, be on the lookout for a lot of the stingrays and the beautiful fish that swim around here. Here is section 5 of Chill Island at CocoCay. So it is probably my least favorite, even though this is where I hung out today. It is probably my least favorite of all of the sections. There is always plenty of seating here. It's somewhere where a lot of people don't come to because it is the furthest away from everything. So it is certainly a bit of a hike. If you want to take the shortcut, come up beside of the Oasis Lagoon to come to this location. It'll save you a lot of time versus walking all of Chill Island and the other sections that we just covered. It also will have some of the noise bleed from the Oasis Lagoon. So the music that is playing at the Oasis Lagoon, you will be able to hear here. So if you want to hear that music, that is great. But if you're looking for more of a relaxed environment, this might not be the spot for you. The other thing I'll say is that there is not much water here. And when you look out to the water, you're gonna see the overwater cabanas, which are beautiful. I love the overwater cabanas. You can see the video that I'll link up above about my review of the overwater cabana. But if I'm looking out from a beach chair, I wanna be able to see miles away, not just to the people that I'm gonna be jealous of enjoying themselves on the overwater cabana. There's also not a lot of actual water here. So as you can see, it is low tide now, and the water has pulled away from the shore, leaving very little room for you to get into the water. Even when the water is fully in, it's very, very shallow, and so you kind of have to lay on your back to be fully submerged. And today has been a scorcher of a day. In September, there is very little breeze coming through. I don't know if you can see the palm trees that are not really moving, but it is hot today. So make sure that, you know, you're really understanding what this area brings, if this is the experience you want to have. Again, my least favorite doesn't mean that you're not gonna love it. Some people probably will like to come here just to check it out, but make sure you know what you're getting yourself. And here is the exclusive content from the Ocean Club at CocoCay, the Coco Beach Club. So I do not have the pass to get in here, but I did go a few weeks ago. I'm going to cut to some of the images that you can see from there, but it is a great time. It does come for a higher price, and that's going to depend on your sailing, the date that you're here, the ship that you're on. There's all sorts of things that go into it. It's going to be different for every single sailing. If it is something you want to splurge on, I highly recommend it. The food in there is fantastic. They have a lot of day beds, places to hang out, and a beautiful infinity pool overlooking the ocean. But this is more of an exclusive or elite experience for those of you that are looking for that kind of true getaway. But this is the Beach Club at CocoCay. Here we have Harbour Beach, which is probably one of the more confusing beaches to me for what all that it offers. But it seems to do really well, and people gravitate towards it. I would say a lot of people that come here are families, people that want a little bit more calmer water. So as you see, this is a harbor. So you're not gonna see all the marine life coming in here that you may see out at the chill island beaches. You also are gonna have beautiful views of the cruise ships behind me. So if you love looking at cruise ships, this is another option for you. There's always plenty of seating here. You've got bean bags at each side. And for those people who may have mobility issues, it is really easy to get to. It is right over the bridge, and it's also gonna have you right beside of the food venues. So you've got Skipper Jack's as well as the Chill Grill that you are within steps to getting to. So this is a very conveniently centrally located beach, and it's also beside of the Oasis Lagoon. So if you want to go back and forth, but you want to keep your home base over here, you can certainly do that. The one thing or disadvantage that I find to this is that you are right beside the zip line landing over my shoulder. So when the zip lines are running, they're actually a little bit loud. They make a loud clanging noise when they go and then when they land. To some folks, this may not bother you, but wanted to call it out that if you're looking for that truly peaceful serenity environment, the zip line coming through every now and again can be a bit awkward. All right, thanks for joining me on this scorcher of a day to hear about the 9 different beach options here at Perfect Day CocoCay, Royal Caribbean's private island, so that when you come for your perfect day, you'll know exactly which one is the best fit for you. So if you've enjoyed this video, make sure that you're sailing on into that subscribe button down below, giving us a thumbs up, and we look forward to seeing you on a weekend cruise soon.